ओके एक्चुअली टाइमलेस ऑथेंटिकेशन इन द टाइमलेस ऑथेंटिकेशन सो वी हैव स्टडी अपटिल नाउ दैट अ की चेन सपोर्ट्स multiple cables. Okay. And out of the multiple keys, it sends the lowest number key. Okay, that we have studied. And the key it will send, it will depend on the validity. Now we will be using the time base, so the validity of the key it is sending, the key number validity today will be based on time.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there are two values. They are how one is the accept lifetime. In the accept lifetime, it decides in what time interval or frame. The key is valid, okay, to be received. And in the sent lifetime, similarly, in what time frame the key is going to be sent. Okay. And one concept that we will be using here, we will be overlapping the, that is the overlapping of accept lifetime. So that is a concept that is little bit, what I can say, you have to be little bit logical to understand it, why we use the overlapping of the accept time with the set time. Okay. And also because the key can be mismatched, you know, for example, if your device is not, is the case, if your device is not sync with each other time. For example, if you are not using NTP, not use NTP server, you are not using, you know what NTP, right? Okay, for example, NTP you are not using server, and how we will be doing it today, what I would say, the time based authentication by rotating the keys. Okay, so today we will be doing it by rotating the keys. We'll be doing the rotation of the keys. Okay, so let's talk about this. What is the concept of this? Overlapping of the time, what does it mean? For example, that is our chart. Okay, let's say here is the that is the time, and this is for keys. For example, that is the starting 0, 1, 2, 3, okay, 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are the different instances of time. So we will be using the key 1, key 2, key 3 and key 4. So what we will be using, we will be sending the key 1 from for example, let's say from the time of the starting from 0 and up to the 1, I am sending the key 1. Okay. From 1 to 2 time interval, I am sending the key 2. From another time interval, I am sending the key 3. Okay. From 3 to 4 instance of time in this interval, I am sending key 4. Okay.
Yeah.
But the acceptance, I will be actually increasing the acceptance time because of the time mismatch. Because two devices, maybe they will be having a certain different time. For example, I will be increasing the acceptance time of the key from little bit to the because this time, if you would see, the acceptance time of key 1 is overlapping with the send time of key 1 and the send time of key 2. Means in this particular time, it will also be accepting the key 1 as well as also will be accepting the key 2. For example, if I would take for the key 2, then key 2 I will be doing like this, somewhat in between. So in this time, if you are able to see, I'm overlapping this time. So in this
different continents like US and India.
US and India. Basically, if you will be make neighborship, they are in different time zones. So you have to see with the time zone also. For example, US and India, they are in different time zone. Okay.
So yeah, that's also. So I was thinking here that our difference will be pretty more. So in that case.
That case, you have also to think about the time. You have to think about taking the two devices into the same time zone. You'll be using the same time zone. There can be the minute difference, hour difference, but the time zone difference that you have to really think about. Okay.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah, because here only 1-2 hours difference we can manage, but that is like day different.
Yeah.
So 2 hours more than that.
Exactly. So if you would think about this, so I am actually overlapping this time. You know, this acceptance time this particular time I'm overlapping with the, in this time it is also accepting the key one and also accepting the key two. Okay, and also sending the key one. So if you would see, this is the overlapping time. Yeah. Overlapping, intersecting. In this particular time, it is in this time. It is also able to, because of there can be the time difference on these two devices. Because of the time difference, I'm doing this. If I would say in this also I would be doing this. And on the last key, what we will do, we will make it up to the infinite of the last key. Generally, if you would see for the normal, I will do like this. But in our practical, I will make it to up to the acceptance to that infinite and up to the sending time to the infinite at the last key. Okay. So the keys keep on rotating. So if you would say this is the send, this is the accept, and this is for the send. That I'm using in this. If you would see, we are accepting the key for a little bit longer amount of time. So maybe if they are having the time difference, and for example, if the neighboring device is sending the key, that is that you have sent the time, there is a certain time difference on it. So for example, if you have started a device, you have set a time 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, and on that device, when this device has 2, this device is having a time 0, 1, 2, and 3. So if you would see, there is a 2 second time in it. So what I would be doing, for example, if I set in this device to send the key for the 5 second, key one, it is sending, and in this time it is sending the key one. Okay, so in this particular moment there will be 6 on this device and there will be 5 on that device, so it will be sending the key two. That is a key one. So it is sending, in this moment it is sending the key one. Okay, so in this time this device will send the key one. Okay, and this device will also sending me the key one. This device will be sending the key two, and this device will be sending the key one. So I will increase its acceptance time to overlap so that it can be able to do the smooth transition from one key to another. I will increase this acceptance time. For example, I will increase acceptance to 2 more seconds. Okay, are you getting it? So I will increase. Exactly. And for that device, what I will do, I will also increase its acceptance times to like this. For example, it will start accepting the key two before its time. Okay. For example, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And because it will start sending the key two from here. Let's again make it another diagram. For example, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this is having the 0 on this 0, 1, 2. And 8. I have set the key interval of 5 because here up to here, what it will be sending? It will be sending the key one for the 5 seconds on this device also from here to here. It will sending the key one, and from here to here, it will sending the key two. And from here, So on, it will be sending the key to you. So because of the time difference of the two device, for this 2 seconds, if I don't set the accept lifetime, overlapping lifetime, for this two particular seconds, then neighborship will broke.
Yeah.
Their neighborship will broke, will break. They will terminate their neighborship for these two particular seconds. So now what I will do, for this I will increase its accept time of the key 2 to overlap with the key 1 send time. I will start accepting the key 2 from before the 5, before the transition, so that if there is a time difference between the device, it should be compensated by the accept lag, because in that time frame it will start accepting the key 2. Okay, do you get it? This is the overlapping of the time. This is the overlapping. Okay, do you get this total idea? So let's move on into the practical. Okay.
For any authentication method, I'm setting the time, or setting the time. That time I can adjust like this.
Yeah, you can do like this. We will see how we are going to do it. Okay, so
apart from any routing protocol, also let's say any authentication method, I'm giving on any real connection or LAN connection. That time also I can use this kind of method.
Actually, this is the authentication method, because we will be rotating the keys. You know, if the keys will not match what the R1 is sending.
I'm saying that this authentication, apart from this routing protocol, anywhere I can use where I need to use the authentication, right?
Exactly. Okay, now it is fine. Okay, let's just configure the router first. Okay, so neighborship has come up. Now again, we will specify here. We will be using the keychain authentication, keychain. Let's type it, the Cisco. Okay, key number is 1. Okay, Sarup.
Yeah.
Key number is 1, and the key string is, let's say, lock 1. Okay.
key
And
number
now,
one, key lock one.
for the key one. Now we will be specifying the send lifetime. Send lifetime, for example, let's say from the starting 00, okay, and the date is 13 December 2016. Okay, up to, let's say I'm doing it for just for the 30 second, we will be taking the time from 00 to 30 second. Again, 30 December 2016. Okay. And the accept lifetime. Accept lifetime. I will be increasing it a bit. For example, let's say from 0000, and I will be December. 00 up to what interval? Let's say up to 45 seconds. You see, I am accepting the key one for a little bit a longer time than I am sending it. 13 December 2016. Sorry. What is the problem? Okay, I haven't specified the year. So that was for key one. For example, now we will be taking the key two. Key string, let's say lock two. Okay, send lifetime. Now I will be changing the send lifetime from 0/0. It was up to 30. Okay, 30 December 2016. So I am for the send lifetime, I will use the exact boundary. For example, here you will see I am sending it from 0 to 30, and this key I will be sending from 30 to 1 minute. Okay, are you with me, Suru?
The two keys different time I am setting.
Yeah, because for
we can set here 5 keys also.
Yeah, we will be setting it. You can set here 5 keys, 6 keys. Because
different
for example, time. Yeah, for example, this key will be sent from 00 to 30 second.
Yeah, okay. 30 second to 1 minute.
Yeah. This key will be 30 second from 1 minute. But for the key one, I have increased the accept lifetime beyond the send lifetime.
Here you send 30 seconds or 30 minutes.
Yeah, that I have done wrong. I have set it to be. We will change it. Okay. First, let's set it 30 seconds. Okay. That is the send lifetime and accept lifetime. I will be accepting this key before even sending it. For example, I will be accepting it 00 from 50 seconds. 15. 13 December 2016. Okay, up till beyond the sending time, 0 minute, 00 01 15, 13 December 2016. Okay, let's move on to the exit. Let's move on to the key one. Key string was lock one. And we have what we have done the mistake of the send time. Okay,
tell me here one second that 00 015, so difference you have taken.
Yeah, I am accepting it before the send time, and even I am accepting it after sending the send time. Okay, I am accepting.
15 seconds have you taken from the first key, that 30, 45 minus 30.
No, I'm using it for the key two. So if the other device is time difference there and it is sending me the key two before 30 seconds, let's say they have a somewhat time difference. So I'm accepting that even before, and maybe the device would be having the time difference and it will be sending the key beyond the 1 minute. So I will also accept that for the 15 minute window beyond the 1 minute while I am sending it. Do you get it?
Show me the first lock.
Yeah, first lock we have done the mistake. For example, we have set the send lifetime to 30 minutes. So I am changing the send lifetime. So send.
It means I'm not saying. I'm saying the except you have said same. Here I could have done some different configuration.
Okay, we will just wait a minute. Let me do the first write that I'm done. And 00 till 13 December 2016. Okay.
Now accept time, if I'm putting the difference. Yeah, like 00 00.
So here is what up till now we have done. Okay. You can see it.
Here, suppose accept lifetime, if I'm giving here pin.
Swaroop, I'm not getting you, your voice is breaking.
Can you hear me now? Hello?
Yeah.
I'm saying that for Q1, suppose I'm giving accept send, first of all I'm setting, so send 0 second to 30 seconds, fine. Except suppose I'm giving 10 seconds to 50 seconds. Will it be okay?
10 second to 15 second.
50, 50, 50.
Yeah, it is okay. So that will depend on your configuration. For example, in this example, I'm taking a windows in seconds, so that we will be able to see the key rotation.
There is no such calculation keeping the difference and all, right?
Basically, here we are doing the key rotation in the seconds, and generally you will see key rotation will be happening the week wise, day wise, month wise. Okay, so you have to think about that in terms of overlapping. So you will be overlapping the seconds, you will be overlapping the days. So what you will be overlapping?
So that time I have to calculate.
For example, if you are rotating, changing your keys within a span of 1 month, so you will be overlapping days. Okay, some 1 or 2 days. Yeah, 1 or 2 days before or 1 or 2 days after. Okay, and you are overlapping keys. For example, I would say in weeks, then you will be overlapping the hours. Maybe 24 hours before. Okay,
yeah.
Like that thing. So you have to think about the overlapping, because in this example we would want to see the key rotation. We would not be taking the time interval of weeks or days. We would be not sitting here and watching the key rotation in that time. We would not be able to watch the key rotation. Okay, so now here everything is fine. Let's move on to the key 3. Key string is lock 3. Okay, the send lifetime would be from 00. See, when it is ending, it's send lifetime. I will be starting from there. Okay, so 01 00, 13 December 2016. Okay, up to 00 01 to 30 December 2016. Okay, and the accept lifetime, I will take a window. Okay, for example, I will start accepting it from the 00 45 00, 13 December 2016. Okay, and I will accept it even after that. Let's say 00 01 45, 13 December.
You have 45 minutes.
Okay, so that is the thing. Okay, now it is fine. Okay, so that is for the key 3. Now let's move on to the key 4. That will be our last key. Okay, key 4. string log 4, okay, send lifetime. I will be sending it from, suppose that is my last key, so I will be sending it from the 00 01 30 13 December 2016 up to infinite. Sorry, infinite. Okay, then accept lifetime. I will be using it. I will be expecting it even before that time. That I would say 01. Sorry. 00 01 15 13 December 2016 up till infinite. Okay.
Yes.
So done. If we would see that rule, so let's move to that. Show key chain. So these are my keys. When you will see the keys will be valid, then there will be the valid statement. When the key is valid, for example, that key will be on the particular time instance, that key will be valid, means acceptance and the send. What key are you accepting and what key you are sending? So here will be valid, now will be seen with that key. For example,
type here one thing, that last R1 show clock.
So basically that's why these two keys are showing valid, because today, okay, that's why these two, for example, if you see this show clock, the time is 10, 14, 11, and that is this one.
UTC, okay, okay.
So let's become this. Okay, so let's go to the interface, serial 1 slash 0.
So bringing router 1 query till router
this one.
UTC, okay, okay.
So let's become this. Okay, so let's go to the interface, serial 1 slash 0, and type on the authentication mode EIGRP 1 MD5. IP authentication. See, the neighbor slip is down.
Down, yeah, because other side I don't have key, that's why.
Yeah, it will be sending the key pool and you don't have the authentication, even authentication configured. IP authentication. Keychain Cisco. Before that is the EIGRP one. Debug EIGRP packet. And also let's debug here. So if you will see here, the key 4 will be coming. Authentication is off and missing. Okay, so now what we can do for simplicity, we can go here, okay, and do the unOn show run begin keychain. Here are all the key. So we can do the copy paste. Okay.
We keep the sender configuration notepad and.
Yeah, we can do the copy paste. Just it will work fine. So we go into the other device and type down the symbol. So it's done. Okay, but still the authentication is not coming on because we haven't applied the authentication into
interface.
interface. Yeah, IP authentication. No BIGRP1MD5 and IP authentication. Keychain BIGRP1 will be Cisco. Now let's see. Membership has come up. Okay. Membership is up. If you see here, the message has come. Membership is up. Now we can do what? We can do the debug AIGRP packets and set the clock set 13 December 2016. Okay. Now you would see here the invalid authentication because key one is coming and here it is accepting the show key and here it's accepting the this key. So let's set the time. Okay, now let's see what is happening. Here key two is coming. Let's once again set the time right because I have taken time to set the Okay, now we will see. You see, it is accepting the key one. Key one. And if you will see show keychain. Here, these two keys are valid. Okay. And if you see here, now they have moved to the transition state. You are seeing that these key are valid three because they are overlapping. They are overlapping. It is accepting the key two also, and it is accepting the key one also and sending the key one also. Now the key ID has changed. Now they have done the key rotation. See? And smooth transition, no membership has been opened. You would see here also the key two. If you would move into the time, so you would see at a time, you know, these three keys you will be shown as valid. Two keys will be shown as valid because they are overlapping. I have set an overlapping time. Okay. Now, for after some time, they will move into the key three. Now they have moved into the key three. If you would see now, so these keys are valid. These three. Okay, and finally they will move into the key four. At 4:30 they will move on the now they move on to the key four. Okay. They have moved into the key four. And without breaking any membership, the smooth transition is happening. Okay. And if you see the show clock, that is 150, and if you see the show clock, they are having a little bit of time difference also.
Yeah.
If there would have been no, what I would say, no overlapping time, definitely. Even for the 1 second difference, they will be having the membership termination message.
Yeah.
Okay, if you would see here, where is that gone? If you would see this thing. If you would see, that is what we have configured. So for in this time window, so we will first see this at 00 time started up to 00:30 key 1, and from the key 2 we have started sending it from 00:30, that is the ending point of the key 1, to the 1 minute, and from 1 minute we have started sending the key 3 up to 1:30, and from 1:30 we have started to set the key 4 up to infinite. And let's talk about the overlapping of the acceptance time. The acceptance time, because it was a starting, so I haven't overlapped it because the time will don't go into the minus, but I have extended it beyond its sending time. Maybe because of the device, the peer device can be having the different time. Okay. And here also I have started before the sending lifetime, I have started to accept it, and I have stretched it beyond the endpoint of the sending of the second key. Are you able to see? That is the send time and that is the acceptance time. Starting of the acceptance time and ending of the acceptance time. The same goes with the key 3. The sending time is 100 and I have started to accept it before 1 minute, and the ending time is to key to send key 3 is 1:30, and I have extended to accept it beyond the 1:30. Okay, the same with the key 4. I have started to send it 1:30, I have started to accept it before 1:30. Okay, so that is the thing for the smooth transition. That was the time based key rotation that we have covered. Okay. If you have any query regarding to it, please shoot, otherwise we will be moving forward.
Yeah, we can go forward.
Okay, that will be the unall. It will be utilizing my computer story. So unall, and let's move into the... So you totally need, we totally need the, and it is really confusing, you know, student don't understand the time based authentication. It is somewhat of logical thinking of the overlapping, why the overlapping is done and why we have.
But it is the basic thing that what actually I was thinking that would be somewhat tougher, like what you said. Suppose I'm thinking about the real configuration. That,
okay.
Day wise, month wise, year wise, that would be like somewhat tough, right?
Not somewhat tough, just you have to practice.
I mean, like practice, yeah. Depend on the practice level.
Yeah, practice level too.
Yeah.
You will be just changing the time, you know. You will be just changing, overlapping the days. Here we have overlapped the second. Just difference between that, you will be overlapping the days. You will be somewhat in the week.
So it is 24 hours maximum.
For what?
No, 24 hours for that time period, I can say. Sorry, 24 hours, yeah. 24 hours, 24 minutes. Like, suppose I want to change 3 days, 3 days wise.
Just start it from 00, 00, and 00. For example, that is your sending time. And what will be the ending? For example, the ending starting will be 13 December 2016. And it will be 0
16 December. Zero. Okay, understood.
Yeah, exactly. You can change the date. That's it. Okay.
So, date specific time. Really.
Exactly. Okay, so now